as I read the book was basically saying to go natural. The book was talking about going natural, and that's the best way for you to improve the health of your hair. And I was in the state of mind, and I was frustrated with my hair, and I was just like, you know what, I'm just gonna cut my hair off. And in the book they talked about the big chop and everything, and I said, I'm gonna cut my hair off, and I'm just gonna go for it. And I did. I cut my hair, and I went to a barber. And I never gone to this barber before. I just walked in out of the blue. I was like, I just want to cut all my hair. I just want to cut it all off. And he did not cut all the perm of it off, all the perm off. So it was like short, but there was still perm on the end. So it was looking crazy. It was sticking up. And eventually, maybe 2 or 3 weeks, I can't remember, I cut that off. I cut off the little perm, you know, on the tips and everything. But I really went through it. When I say I went through it, I went through it. At the time, I was working as a journalist. I was a newspaper reporter. And this guy, I think that I was an education reporter, and I believe that he was like an assistant principal or something. He was some kind of administrator in the school. He told me that I made the biggest mistake of my career by cutting my hair off. I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe that he had the gall to tell me that, like, that he had the nerve to just tell me that, you know. He's like, you made a big mistake. And I said, what is it? I'm thinking he's talking about something in the article or something, you know, that I misquote you or something. He's talking about my hair. And I remember thinking, like, what right do you have to tell me how I should wear my hair and how, you know, I'm making a mistake in my career because of my hair? Because my job, you know, they never say anything negative or anything about my hair. I didn't even get any bad vibes from them about my hair. Like, you know, you can kind of tell if they're like, oh, so what are you doing? Or, you know, nothing like that at all. Most of the negative comments that I got were from our people, my people. My family wasn't too happy. I have one family member, my grandfather, who teased me relentlessly. Hello again. I finished doing my hair, and as you can tell, I just went and put it on the pipe cleaners, excuse me. Alright. And I did that, like, because, you know, it's easier, it's a little bit neater, and although it looks, like, really, really puffy, I'm going out of town with my hair like this, ha ha ha, yeah. I am going to Thailand, and I am extremely excited. I'm leaving tomorrow in the morning, which is January the 15th, so by the time you see this, I may already be in Thailand, but I am thrilled. I am so thrilled to go. I'm super duper excited, and I'm going to wear my hair like this there, because as soon as I get there, as soon as it's feasibly possible, let me put it this way, I plan to hit the beach and escape some of this cold weather. It's not freezing super duper cold in Busan, South Korea, where I'm located. It's probably equivalent to the way it is in Georgia now, which I guess you guys will say that it is extremely cold, but it's like in the 30s here now, I think. About 30 degrees Fahrenheit, I think it is. Sometimes it has been to be down to like 20s, but in the northern part of South Korea, like in Seoul, where a lot of people go to teach, because it's like the hot spot, one of the hot spots. That's the largest city in South Korea. They've had a blizzard, from what I understand. The weather is like, went below zero, and it's just like extremely bitter cold there. So I am just so thankful that I'm not there. But anyway, getting back to Thailand, I am so happy to go. I'm going to be gone for 9 nights, which is a long time, you know, for me to go on just a vacation. Yes, I've gone different places and lived there for, like, you know, for briefs of time, I mean spans of time, but I don't think that I have just, I think this is like the longest vacation, touristy type vacation that I have been on, 9 nights. So I cannot wait to go, and I am going to, I really wanted to kind of document me going there, like taking the bus and then to the airport, and then, you know, at the airport, and then when I get to Bangkok, but I'm afraid that I won't have enough battery on my camera to do that, so I don't think I'll be able to, I don't know, maybe I can. I guess I'll try it, and then I'll try to charge my camera up when I get there. But anyway, I am so happy. I cannot wait. I can't wait. I can't wait. I can't wait. I can't wait. I'm packing. Well, I'm almost packed. I'm just about packed. I just have like a few things to throw in to my my carry-on bag, and I will be ready to go. So everyone, pray for my safe arrival, and if I take time to upload this, and if I don't see you or be able to talk to you again, like soon before I get back, goodbye for now. But I will be posting a video and pictures and whatnot of what it's like in Thailand, and I may put more information on my blog. You know, because I like to write, and I can write more about it and, you know, post pictures and video there as well. But anyway, it's nice to talk to you guys, and